shopping. Step inside a very special supermarket. The only supermarket in the world that gives you money. £2,000 is waiting on our shelves to be won by some lucky person in this store. The aim of the game is to shop smarter and faster than the next person. And everything in this supermarket is up for grabs. Go on, fill your trolleys as high as you can, because shopping has never been so much fun. Yes, there's prizes in store and much, much more when you play Dale's Supermarket Sweep. So let's welcome today's shoppers, who are Get Greenhouse and Linda Bamber from Lancashire, Simon Barker and Debbie Edwards from Essex and London, and Julia Jackson and Sue Staniland from Nottinghamshire. You're all on Dale's Supermarket Sweep. And here's your host, Dale Winton.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Hi, welcome to Supermarket Sweep. Hello, gorgeous shoppers.
Hello.
Oh, you see, they're so happy, they're smiling, because they know that this could be the day they go home with £2,000. Well, I hope you do it. Building up time on your clocks is the name of the game. With that thought in mind, just because it's you and I love you today, you're going to have a minute to start with each. And this card is worth 10 seconds to you. It's the mini sweep and £25 in your subtotal. What product am I looking for? I wish you luck. For a drink, I'm sure you'll agree. You can't beat a pot of... Linda.
Teedale.
Absolutely right. Best drink of the day. Best drink of the day. You got the 10 seconds, which means, well, you're halfway there. Debt, you've got to run the mini sweep. Somewhere out there is a box of tea. Got one of these on the sweep logo. Get it back to me within 30 seconds, and I'll give you £25 on your subtotal. So you're looking for a box of tea. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I fancy a cuppa. Off you go. Oh. Sweetheart. Oh, I gathered that. I am so upset because I really wanted a cup of tea. Oh, never mind. But listen, the 25 quid is here nor there. You got the 10 seconds, which you'll make up for when you do the trolley dash a bit later on. So go and join Linda. I'll come over myself. You are so welcome today, you two. You're gorgeous. Welcome to Supermarket Sweep. But I've got to ask you, the name Debt, this is really unusual. Because when I knew you were coming on today, I said, Debt, and nobody could tell me what that was short for. Is it, or is that it?
That's short for Bernadette.
Oh, Bernadette, of course. Childminder and taxi driver.
Yeah.
That's you. That's an unusual combination, isn't it? And I'm told you get proposals in the cab. I wouldn't want her driving me, I tell you. That laugh is something else. No, I love it. So, but your husband works on the radio, is that
he
right?
He owns the firm, so right. I drive for him when he's short-staffed.
Right, and then when he's in the car, he can hear if people are talking to you, because he's got the radio.
Yeah.
So do you tell them that your husband's listening?
Eventually.
Oh, you little flirt. You little flirt. But you're very welcome today, Debt and Linda. Simon and Debbie, welcome to Supermarket Sweep. Whose idea was it to come on the sweep today?
Mine, Dale.
It was yours, yes. Simon. It says here, and I'm not going to ask you to do this, but I'm just fascinated, you can play the EastEnders theme on a piece of toilet paper and a comb.
I can. It's my party piece.
Your party piece. You'll be relieved to know I haven't got a comb or a piece of toilet paper handy. I haven't. But what I am curious about is, you see, when people write in for Supermarket Sweep, we say, special talents, are you gifted in any special way? And Simon is renowned for his big yellow one.
It's to do with my work.
What's your big yellow one, and do I want to see it?
No.
Right. What is it?
It's actually broken at the moment.
Oh.
It's out of use.
I've got. Well, if it's what I think it is, I've got aisle 7. I've got some lovely ointment and lotion out there. What actually
it's
is it?
It's just a big yellow calculator I use for demonstration purposes at work.
And it's yellow.
All my members. I'm renowned for my big yellow one.
How are you? Are you? Oh well. might find it a bit later on. I wish you luck, Debbie and Simon. Julia and Sue, you're very welcome to Sweet Day. You've been giggling from the moment you got here today. You're having a really good day, I know you are. Unusual habits. Well, first of all, occupation. You're a hairdresser as well, Sue, is that right?
Yeah.
And you're a bank clerk. How long have you been friends then?
Too long, really.
About 10 years.
Yeah. And didn't you become friends because someone recommended someone to have their hair cut and it was a 100-mile trip? Well, how did that work? What happened?
It's a client from hell. I just wish she'd never said anything.
So you're the client from hell?
She's the hairdresser from hell.
Right, OK. And you're still friends?
Yeah.
My goodness. So what happened exactly then? You were recommended to go to Sue?
I moved up to the area and I was still going back where I used to live to have my hair cut.
Right.
So, and then I was recommended.
And then you've been friends ever since, which is great. Well, I wish you both lots of luck. You're very welcome, Sue and Jules. Linda, Simon, and Julia. Well, I will see you later on for a game, but for now, thank you. Debbie, and Sue, step forward. We'll put some time on those clocks. Okay. 10 seconds to throw, we're going to play Odd One Out. You all get to play choice of three. Here we go. Now, which one of these is not associated with meat? Is it one, the schnitzel? Is it two, the Kiev? Or three, the cracknell? Please vote, make your choice. One, two, or three. One of those is not associated with meat. Which one is it? Debt, what do you reckon?
One, Dale.
You said one, the schnitzel. And Debbie?
Two, Dale.
The Kiev and
Sue? One, Dale.
One, the schnitzel. Actually, believe it or not, it's three, the cracknell. It's a type of biscuit.
No.
Disgruntlement from the audience there. Oh, dear. Here's another three for you. Which one of these is not a type of cream? Is not a cream? Is it one, the clotted, two, the fresh, or three, the tiramisulata? Please vote again. One, two, or three. Is not a type of cream. Which one is it? Debt.
Three, Dale.
Three, tiramisulata. And Debbie?
Three, Dale.
And Sue?
Three, Dale.
Of course, it's a Greek dish. Well done. You've all added 10 seconds. Good. Now, one of these, and only one, is not a type of toast. Interesting. Which one of these is not a toast? Is it tipsy, Melba, or French? Please vote. Make your choice. One, two, or three. Debt.
One, Dale.
One, the tipsy. And Debbie?
One, Dale.
And Sue?
One, Dale.
You know your food. Of course, it's a type of cake. You've all added 10 seconds. Good. We're now going to play Rhyme Time. I'm going to give you two clues. I'm looking for two words that rhyme to make up the right answer. For example, were I to say to you, an Australian wild dog and a game of chance, hopefully you'd say dingo and bingo. Here we go. A juicy fruit with a stone and a strip of mint-flavoured chew. Sue?
Plum and gum, Dale.
Plum and gum's right. Well done. A popular shellfish, and you mow this. Sue?
Prawn and lawn, Dale.
Prawn and lawn, you're good at this. Rhyme time, good. This one's a joint of meat, and turn over a new one of these. Debbie?
Beef and leaf, Dale.
Beef and leaf is right, well done. This grills bread, and the other one protects the table from ring marks. Sue?
Toaster and coaster, Dale.
Toaster and coaster, good. The clocks tell a very interesting tale, but you'll have to wait till we bring back your partners to let you know exactly how well you're doing, so let's welcome them back. OK. Linda and Debt, very close. It's even Stevens, you've got 1 minute and 30. Simon and Debbie, you also have 1 minute and 30. And Julia and Sue, 1 minute and 50. Plenty more time to play for. For now, Debt, Debbie and Sue, thank you for joining us. I'll see you later on for the round robin. But returning players, your chance to have a game. Higher or lower, one of my famous fabulous pricing games. Now, the marvellous thing is, if you get this one right, all along the line, you can pick up 30 seconds in total. Have a look at what I bring you first of all. We've got a packet of tortilla chips, which I will sell to you for 69 pence. But consider the jar of mustard. Would that be higher or lower in price than the tortilla chips? Please vote higher or lower. Make your choice. You've all voted and we have a difference of opinion. Linda's gone lower, Simon's gone higher and Julian's gone lower. The jar of mustard in my supermarket's 53. Lower is what I was looking for. Well done, Linda and Julie. About 10 seconds. However, now you know what the mustard costs. What do you reckon to the tin of tomatoes? Would they be higher or lower in price than the mustard? Please vote, make your choice. And you've all agreed on lower. I'm pleased to tell you, of course, you're all right. 29 pence. Well done, you've all added 10 seconds. The bargain Tom's at 29 pence, but in comparison to the fruit cocktail, what do you think? Higher or lower in price? Please vote, make your choice. You've all voted higher. Yeah, of course you're right, 55 pence. You've all added 10 seconds to your clock. Good. We're now going to play random reveal. I'm going to give you the answer I'm looking for, but only let you see one letter at a time revealed at random. To help you get there, there will be an initial clue. Now, today all the questions will be associated with pet shops, OK? And your clue for the first one is, the vicar's got one as well. Oh, straight away, Julia.
Dog colour.
Is the right answer. Your clue for this one is, a pet container. Let's have a letter. F. B. H. Simon?
Goldfish bowl down.
Is the right answer. 10 seconds. I'm itching just thinking about it. Oh, they all went for it. Linda?
Flea powder, Dale.
We'll do nicely, that's right, 10 seconds. And this one's a treat for Polly. Let's have a letter. Oh, Simon.
Parrot seed, Dale.
Is not the right answer. Let's have a letter. S. M. E. D. A. E. Julia.
Sesame seed, Dale.
Is the right answer, sesame seed. Sometimes it pays to buzz in really early, sometimes it doesn't. Well, I tell you, you're all doing very well. How well? Just wait a sec. First, let's bring back your partners. Well, happy shoppers all round. Look at you grinning away at me. Let me tell you how well you're doing. We've got 2 minutes for Debbie and Simon. We've got 2 minutes and 10 for Det and Linda. And Sue and Julie, you've got 2 minutes and 40. Here is, yes, here's your last chance, though. What you put on your clocks now is what you'll take with you out there into the supermarket. We call this one the round robin. So, returning players, you're going to go first. Quick change and hopefully give me the right answer. And it's all to do with video movies. Here we go. Which English actor played Smee in Hook? He was also in Roger Rabbit. And the... Debbie.
Bob Hoskins?
Bob Hoskins is right. Change. Which actor talked to the animals in the film Dr. Dolittle? Simon.
Rex Harrison-Dale.
He did. Change. Tony Curtis is her father, and she starred in A Fish Called Debbie.
Oh, I've lost it down.
Oh! In A Fish Called Wanda. Oh, Sue?
Jamie Lee Curtis.
Jamie Lee Curtis is right, change. Who played Shirley Valentine in the film of the same name? Simon. Oh, and you can see her, can't you? Who played Shirley Valentine in the film of the same name? Linda and Julia, do you want to play? No. And she's married to John Alderton. And she was an upstairs, downstairs. The answer actually is Pauline Collins.
Oh, that's
of course, that was their change. Let's have another one. Which young English actress played the female lead in the recent version of the film Titanic? Debbie.
Kate Winslet-Down.
She did. Change. Which American actress has played English women in both Emma and Sliding Doors? Julia.
Emma, what's it?
No, it's too late, too late. Simon.
Emma Thompson-Dale.
It's not the right answer. She's got a funny name. No. Gwyneth Paltrow. Oh, that was her. Never mind. That takes care of the round robin. Here's what you have to go shopping with. Det and Linda, you have 2 minutes and 10. Debbie and Simon, 2 minutes and 30. And Sue and Julia, 2 minutes and 50. Good. You're going to shop till you drop. You're going to shop till you drop. But what I need you to tell me is who's going to be doing the shopping. It'll be Linda, Simon and Julia. Oh, good luck. Come back in a few moments. They're going to go wild in the aisles, hopefully going home with the £2,000. Where else? It's Supermarket Sweep. Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Earlier we saw our teams do very well building up time on their clocks. That's the time they have to go shopping. Pink to go first. Julia and Sue, you did so well. You have 2 minutes and 50. followed by Simon and Debbie in the blue. You have 2.5 minutes, 2:30. And then the yellow team, Det and Linda, with 2:10. But like I always say, it's not what you got, it's how you use it. OK? So I wish you luck. Have a look around the supermarket. You can do what you like. Trash it, just load those trolleys high and wide. Grab an inflatable if you see one. They're worth between £25 and £100. One to a shopper, please, if you don't mind. Rosie's over there at the Pick and Mix. She'll help you weigh out 5 varieties of sweets, but it must be to the weight and value of 500 grams. If you do that, I'll give you 50 quid on your subtotal. Also, the pricing gun over there, all those tins need labelling. Manage that, and I'll give you 50 quid, OK? I've also got a shopping list. This is worth £100. One of each of these items, please. I need you to bring me back a box of cling film, a packet of basmati rice, and a carton of orange juice. One of each of those, 100 quid on your subtotal. It begs one question. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes!
Good, I'm glad to hear it. Julia and Sue, get ready, because off you go.
Off you go indeed is Julia marching into the market melee this afternoon and using the time advantage that she's got wisely at the Pick and Mix. And Sue's happy with that. She obviously likes a sweet as well. Oh, pick that up, please, Julia. Racy's got her eagle eye on you there.
One, go!
And there's Simon for the blue team as he races into the marketplace. Oh, hey, nice bit of footwork from him over at the nappies. Yeehaw! And baby's milk. Well done, Simon. It's the pricing gun this time for Julia. And it's the big bouncy banana bonus for Simon. Whoa, hey, mind that. Hey, it's pointing in the right direction for Linda as she gets away for the yellow team. And she picks up a big bouncy burger bonus. And the tins are nicely priced up with Julia. And here's Simon. He's making a banana cocktail in the off license. Now, this is the orange juice on Dale's shopping list. Well done, Julia. Oh, hello. It's Sue and Stu at the checkout. Where are you? I'm over here, says Julia. And Linda for the yellow. What's up? You're looking. It's right in front of you, Julia. Now Linda's trying to make up for that lost time. That's the cling film on Dale's shopping list for Simon. And the tins are being priced up there with Linda. That's the cling film for Julia as well. Another shopping list item. And a new trolley. A good turn there from Linda. And we're going towards the frozen veg. Simon's doing well, isn't he? Look at that for a good pirouette of a turn. Oh, hello. And the turkeys have landed for Julia. She's gobbling up the bunny there. And so is Linda down at the frozen foods. And look at this for frantic shopping. In amongst the garden equipment, the trolley's running away from her. And it's ready meals for Julia. And it's spices. Now then, that's the basmati rice on Dow's shopping list. Those are the tins nicely priced up for Simon. He heads down towards the Pick and Mix. And we're spicing up Linda's life in amongst the spices there. And Simon's at the Pick and Mix at the sweets. And mind that mop handle, Julia. Ooh, we're enjoying this today, aren't we? Now, yes, I'm sure we are. She's talking to herself now, Linda is. And Simon gets the sweets weighed up. Oh, and a bit of trolley trouble there for Linda as Simon gets the pans and he pulls the trolley down the other end of the market into the fizzy drinks. Come on, Simon. Look at this. Look at the concentration on his face. It's the cling film for Linda. That's on Dow's shopping list. Took no chances, took one of each. And Simon's got his trolley back to front there. We go around the corner with Julia and a new trolley for Linda. Oh, and the CDs have crashed down. CDs crashed down. I like it, Simon. And there we go, trying to fill up this trolley. Oh, look, pick them up, Simon. It's frozen chips going in for Julia. You've had your chips, Julia. The countdown's on. That's the orange on the shopping list. And that's it. Back to Dale.
Did they do the shopping list? Did they get the inflatable? And thank you, Bobby, for guiding us through that wild sweep. We're going to let the girls check all these things through the till, find out who's going to go for the super sweep. So let's check them out. Let's do those shopping totals. Well, it's been a fierce sweep today, I tell you. Look at this. Linda and Det. Well, where do we begin? The burger's a good idea. The bonus, what's it worth, my sweet?
25 quid,
good. Now then, this is looking very promising, because if I'm not mistaken, that's a full shopping list.
Yes, yeah.
And you got the Pick and Mix, so you've got 150, and you did the pricing gun as well as another 50. When you add that, of course, with a bonus, you've got a subtotal of £225.
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful. Which, when I add the value of the goods in your trolley, gives you a grand total on sweep today of £289.
Aww.
Good. Simon and Debbie in the blue. Let's have a look. Well, you got the inflatable bonus. Now, that's got to be worth something.
£100.
100 quid. Good. Well shot. And also, is that a full shopping list?
Yes, Dale.
100 quid and pick a mix as
yes,
well. Another £50 and the pricing gun items. Another £50. My goodness. Your subtotal is £300. I'll add that to the value of the goods in your trolley, gives you a grand total ensuite of £424. Wonderful shot. Wonderful shot. Sue and Julia, you've got to catch them up. My goodness, can you do it? I wonder. Your bonuses?
£50, Dale.
Fabulous, 50 quid, that's good. And you also did the shopping list.
We did, Dale.
I'll give you 100 quid for that. And there's a bag of pick and mix as well.
Yeah.
It's another 50. And the pricing on items as well. You all did very well today. Gives you a subtotal of 250 quid. Now then, I'm going to add that to the value of the goods in your trolley. If it is more than what the blue team got, which is 424, you will be running the super sweep. If not, it will be Simon and Debbie. When I put those totals together, your grand total on sweep today is 366.
Yeah!
The blue team have it. Thank you for being wonderful shoppers. Well, 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 well. Well, isn't that incredible? What do you think?
Amazing.
You can't believe it, can
no,
you?
Not
oh, look, you're sweating, you're so excited. Listen, here's the deal. Somewhere out there in the supermarket, there is £2,000 hidden in cash. Now, I know you can go home with it. You know how it's done.
Yes.
You have 1 minute to find the cash and keep it. The way you do that is you solve the clues on the cars to the three specially marked products. Your money's behind the third item. I'm going to give you the first clue, and your time won't begin until I've finished reading it to you.
Okay.
If you're ready, shall we do it?
Yes,
Dale.
Here we go. Good luck. No meat this time, but you can guess why. A pastry dish, creamy, blank, blank. No meat this time.
Vegetable pie.
Yes! Go!
Pie.
Go!
Ready meals there. Ready meals. Pie, pie. Vegetable pie, vegetable pie. Vegetable pie. Fresh broccoli and silky pie. Read the clue. Read it. Exotic and large, with tasty yellow flesh. Something sliced are definitely best. Mango.
Mango.
Mango. Mango. Mango.
Exotic and large, with tasty yellow flesh.
Yellow flesh. Melon. 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 No, melon's not there. Melon. Exotic and large, with tasty yellow flesh. Something sliced is definitely best.
Five, four, three,
it's not one
bar,
it's sweet.
Come on back, shoppers. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back.
What? Pavlova.
Yeah, it was Pavlova as well, the last clue. But
Pavlova.
You know what threw you? It was that with slices, and you were looking at the fresh pineapple, really should have been going for the slice. The tin, which you got. Oh, I'm so sorry. Did you have a good day?
Brilliant.
Well, you've been wonderful shoppers. You're going
thank
home
you.
With the value of the goods in your trolley. Will that do?
Yes, fantastic.
Thank you so much. That takes care of another day on Supermarket Sweep. And remember, the next time you're at the checkout and you hear the beep, think of the fun you could be having on Supermarket Sweep. Have a good day.